mission outside. Do you agree with me? And that's exactly what's happening in us. Here inside us only there is an opposition party. The mind and the intellect are against. And more often than not, who wins? Bolo. The mind or the intellect? Everyone who smokes. Right on the packet it is written, cigarette smoking is injurious to health. Is it true or not? It's on the packet, it's not even. And then, what happens? What do you have to do? The intellect has to be cancelled and the mind takes over. Oh, it happens. And then the mind is so smart and manipulative that it gets all facts and figures of how the lung cancer rate is really not so much. And there will always be such research done, sponsored by the companies. Isn't it? You'll always find research enough to support anything that pizza is the best healthy food in the whole world. Is it true or not? There is enough research available. If you don't know, I'll give you. So, what happens? Our mind supports all its decisions and says, nah, intellect doesn't know. So what? Everyone does. Why should we not do? Who cares? No one is looking. Why not? Only once. Who cares? Why should I only be good? Everyone is like that. I also. You see, these are all the reasons we give for what? Not listening to our intellect. Is it true or not? Yes, what happens? So therefore, and who is harmed in the whole process? Please tell me. Who is harmed? Because forget about anything outside. You are a disintegrated person. Forget about anything else. You, inside you, there's a split personality. So therefore, this is most desired state for all of us. And whenever this happens, you congratulate yourself, isn't it? I didn't have batatavada. Thank God I didn't have, otherwise I'd have suffered so much. You congratulate yourself at that time. Ha, I did it. Is it true or not? By these small, little doings of ours, the confidence increases, the intellectual power increases, then the mind starts obeying and you remain what is called self-controlled. Is that okay? Give it that little, you know, this, not big things, don't decide on big things, little things, and you will see how you start controlling yourself. Okay, now, normally when we start seeing our mind, seeing our own inner thoughts, we see a lot of things which we may not like. You know, it's difficult sometimes to accept that our mind is what it is. There are certain things which are even more difficult than others to accept. Now, what happens normally, most of us go into one of these four modes. And therefore, it's difficult for us to come out of our weaknesses of the mind. The first thing that someone does whenever they try to see within is escape or deny. Yes? Bolo. If you see also, you don't want to see it. You find that you are jealous and you don't want to accept your jealousy. Ah! Immediately you try to distract your mind and say, no, let's go and have some drink, or let's go and have a party, or you ring up someone and say, oh, let's, because you don't want to see your mind, don't want to live with the weaknesses of their mind. So you distract, if not anything, you switch on the TV and you heroine. You don't mind their weaknesses, but you don't like your weakness. Is it true or not? So the first thing we want to do is escape from seeing our mind, or deny whatever you have already seen. Do you agree with me? In fact, most problems start because of that. You know, even let's say when a person drinks or something, the first thing that happens is self-denial, that person himself denies, and the family denies it, and everyone denies, and therefore the person never manages to get out of it. So one is what? Denial or escaping. Then the second thing that happens is justification. What is that? You justify. If someone says, you know, you are like that, if you were in my place, you also would be like that. You don't know what all I have gone through. You just don't know the pressures that are there on me. What pressures? You don't know, I have to get up in the morning. What to tell you? And if I don't get up, my wife tells me, why don't you get up? What a pressure. Useless. Isn't it? I'm telling you, people with the greatest difficulties in the world that have come, the most, what do you call it, circumstances which we can't even imagine, they come out of it like that. People with no problems make big things of their problems. Have you seen that? Little useless, good for nothing things. When I was small, my teacher told me like that. And nowadays, this psychology has come into. And as a child, I was abused. Means abused means what? My father once slapped me. Arre Rama! I wish he had slapped a few more times. You would have been a better person. Are you understanding what I'm speaking? Some ridiculous justification for everything and anything that we are. I am like that because. I am like that because. And a person who justifies will never, 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 never come out of it. Have you all understood? Because he's already given a cause. So that means there are something else is to be blamed, not him. Are you with me? If you justify, you will never be able to get out of this problem. I am like that, full stop. Not I am like that, comma. I am like that because. I am like that this. No, I am like that, full stop. Justification. The third thing that a lot of people do, when they see some weakness within themselves, they start condemning themselves. I am useless. I am a born failure. Anything I touch, it becomes a problem. In my life, problems come only to me. God only has one address. My neighbor never gets, only I. See what happens? The day I decide to have a party, that day only it will rain. What is my prarabdha? I am telling you. These type of people also never manage to get out of their weaknesses. Self-condemning, guilty, all the time they're whipping themselves inside. Such people, never. No. And that is also a different form of justification. Will you remember that? So such people cannot get out of these weaknesses. I am like that, full stop. Not I am like that. No, I am like that. Objectively. And the fourth thing that people do, and that because of that, they never manage to get out of their weaknesses, identification. I tell you, people of Nairobi now are really, really, really buddhus. What? What? You have the audacity to sit here, come here and call us. Now what happened? Immediately you identified. All of you? Yes or no? Supposing I had said, people of Nairobi, I have never met an audience like that. The most intelligent, the most elevated, kya audience hai? Immediately. Now, this is a speaker we like. What happened? Identification. You understand? You identify. And I tell you the way we identify everything. Kya band besti pagdi? Anything is spoken anyway, immediately. There are some people. You talk of anything under the sun, they will give their own example. Hari, but we are not talking about someone else. We are not talking about you. You say, no, this is very good. Then immediately, we had something like that in our house also. It was like that. Hari, Baba, let me just talk of this now. Why are you bringing yourself in the picture? Have you noticed that? That, of course, is a little bit of this identification with anything. I'll give you examples of that. You'll understand that better. Supposing, this garba ras is now, very soon this will come. No? So then they'll all do garba. The kids will prepare for garbas and all. And then they'll have a performance. And then everyone sits. And then this garba is going on. And there are some 15 girls dancing. Okay? 15 girls and boys, they're all dancing. What do you think the parents, whom will